Hey guys, what's going on? It's Boomer. How you all doing today? I'm actually in a graveyard. I'm not at the graveyard where my stepdad's buried. That's a long story I don't want to get into, but my mother and I decided to come here. This is peaceful. But I'm in Bonaventure graveyard. And this is one of the oldest graveyards in Savannah, Florida. If you look at that, 1903. I mean, we got everything from 2003. This is a whole family. 1938. I mean, apparently there's old cemeteries in here. There's people buried. Oops, sorry. There's some old cemeteries in here. A lot of people were buried. What was it? A lot of people were buried from the 1600s in here. This is one of the oldest cemeteries in Savannah, Georgia. So, we're just going to show you around. You guys see anything? Now, I mean, some of these people, I mean, the 2002, I mean, look at that. That's from 1867 to 1950, 1860 to 1937. Look at these graves. Look at this. This is not Spring Hill Cemetery, that's for sure. I have my stepsister here. She doesn't want to be on camera. She said she would talk on camera, but she'd talk like she's next to me. Oh my gosh, look at this. I'm gonna take some pictures too. Look at that, 1858. Or is that 1643 to 1848? You see that? Let me see that, hold on. Look at that guy, sorry for the... I don't know if that's 18 or 1643. I don't know if I'm reading that right. Or 1843 to 18, it might be 8. Here. So I'm here, I saw this big grave here. My stepsister, she's next to me. She doesn't want to be filmed, but she'll talk, she said. And look at this, look at this. This is from 1799, guys. This is old. This is really 1870. Well, you lived a full life, thank God. Unlike some of these people, a lot of kids in here. So I'm going to do a voice box session with you guys. Is there anybody here like to communicate? Is anybody here? Are you buried here at the cemetery? My name is Jonathan. What is your name? It's not like, my name is Jonathan, it's like... They don't even, look at this, guys. I don't know if they make graves like this anymore. I'm sure they do, but... Age 30 years, 6 months, and 8 days. That's not very long. Died April 29th, 1858. Wow, they had like the exact day.
They do. There's some of them that show you the amount of days.
I don't. Yeah. Do they do that anymore?
No.
No.
Usually it's pretty flat.
I mean, look at those guys.
Because you gotta think, they charge by the letter now for tombstones.
Yeah. Yeah, it's way different nowadays. Then you could probably get the tombstones for like $5 or something. I don't know, $5, but you know what I mean, guys. Wow. Remember, guys, if you see anything, please timestamp it in the chat. So we have... So I'll try this over here. It didn't work over there. Where's my phone? Not in with my water, thank God. So I moved, guys, so let's see if this works. Is there anybody here that would like to communicate? What is your name? Bobby? Did you hear that? Is your name Bobby? Robert. Oh my gosh, guys. I said his name's Bobby. There's two Roberts buried right there. Are you Robert Foster? Your last name Foster? How did you die? You were like, not even, you were just being born. Were you 2 years old? No, it was 43 to 49. Your mother and father, look. Mother and father over here and the kids are over here. That is odd. Wow. Alright, let's go down a little bit. George.
They actually put where they passed away, too.
Age 68 years. Wow, he lived a full life. Yeah, wow.
Yeah, George lived for a minute.
That's not bad at all for the back then.
Yeah.
Well, you know, with the advancement of medicine nowadays. I don't like how they have Catherine, so this must have been his wife. She was 70. She lived a full life, too. He gathered his beloved sleep. He... Safe from the cares of the... Is that wavery? Weary? Weary years in the golden home beyond the sunset. That is so nice. You don't see that nowadays. Like, just so expensive. George, I hope you're resting in peace, man. And your wife, too. I'm sure you are. Hope you were good people. I'm sure you were. Wonder if these people, you know, it makes you think, wonder if these people still have family.
They probably do, because you can trace your lineage back.
Oh, yeah. Well, if they still live here in Savannah, don't worry, I'm not filming it. I mean, I'm sure you could, but just like, do they still live in Savannah? Do they move on to the country? I mean, that's over 100 years now, so. Makes you think, right, guys? Guys, just to let you know, I'm not going to be filming here too much because we're going to go on a ghost tour tonight. I want to be filming that, so I got to save my battery for that. But then again, I think I can plug it in and charge it. Do you guys know anything about power shots? I think I can plug it in, but the thing is, I think I got to turn it on and it charges. I'm not sure about that. I got to look into that. incredible. 1853, oh my gosh, 1821 to 1855, 1822 to 1855, wow. Maria and Ganau? Huh. Ganau, looks like Ganau. Elizabeth Ganau, whole family's here. It's like they have like sections towards the families. Did you notice that too? Wow. Smets. And guys, this place is huge. Like, it is freaking huge. We're not gonna even walk at all. You can do ghost here tours tonight. I'm getting Omar to come with me and we're gonna go ghost touring, so. Okay, guys, I don't know if you're familiar with, if anybody's a history buff, please help me out here. I got a General Robert H. Anderson. Here's his grave up there. This is the restoration project. It's by the Bonaventure Historic Society. That's awesome. I'm glad they're trying to, wow, there's a general. Wonder if he was a popular general. You know anything about him?
No.
That was my sister I was asking. Stepsister, guys. I know I said I had no siblings, but I always forget about to mention my stepsister. I apologize, guys. But she's like a sister to me. She's like a sister, regular. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm tired. Time to get some caffeine. Sorry, Carrie. She's laughing at me. At least I hope she is. This is amazing. Wow. Alright, so some time has passed since the cemetery, it was really cool, and I'm in a downtown, very historic, very beautiful downtown Savannah here, and this is the distillery we're eating there. But over here it's called the Old Savannah Tours, and tonight we're taking the ghost tour. I was telling about you that earlier. My mom's coming with me, and my stepsister, who's like my sister to me. Sorry guys, I don't know if I was pointing myself there. So. We're gonna take the tour. I don't want to get ran over here, so please forgive me if I'm pointing the camera. But we're gonna take the tour, and we'll see how it is. We'll learn some history here in Savannah. So really cool. Well, I figure I'd show you Savannah. I told my mom I'm taking a little bit of a walk. I'll show you a little bit of Savannah. It's really cool. There's a visitor center. Something you're gonna notice about. Savannah, it is an old town. A lot of bricks. Brick buildings. Excuse me. A lot of restoration here, too. I mean, this is a pretty old building, too. I mean, it's...
driving around for about an hour. We're going to be visiting some of the most historic and some of the most haunted spots in the city. Now, at the end of this hour, all of you guys have the stickers on your shirts I saw on my sheet, and I see that you all are wearing them with pride, and that means that all of you guys are going into the Sorrel Weed House at the end of the tour.
Nice.
Now, you guys are going to be in there for about 20-25 minutes. They're going to show you a pretty good time, and we're going to be waiting right outside the Sorrel Weed House for all of you guys, or, well, those of you that do come back anyway. We're going to be waiting for y'all outside the Sorrel Weed House, and we'll take you right back here to the visitor center, or if you have a car parked across the street at the office, we will get you there. If you have one parked here, we'll just let you off. You guys are good to go. So before we get into really, you know, the actual storytelling part of the tour here, well, I want to talk to you guys just a little bit about the types of spirits or the types of haunts that y'all might experience here in the city of Savannah. There are three main types of hauntings that I want to talk to y'all about. They are the three most common, and, well, I guess the three most broad categories. So, the first of which, guys, they're pretty common. I wouldn't be surprised if some of you may have heard the term before, but the first type of haunting that I want to talk to y'all about are called orbs. Now, orbs are very low-energy spirits. They're typically caused by someone, you know, dying of a very low-energy death. Natural causes, stuff like that. And, well, because orbs are so low energy, you can't see them, with your eyes. You can't hear them. They don't make any noise. Not audible. But, and this is why I do highly encourage taking pictures on my tour. So if y'all are hesitant about taking pictures, don't be nervous about it. If you want to take pictures of me, I highly encourage that as well. I want you guys to feel comfortable taking pictures of everything on the tour because, well, orbs generally only show up in photographs. And, you know, on the rare odd occasion, they have been known to pop up in videos, but, I mean, that takes a lot of time and effort to really set up a shot to capture that, and especially since we are on a moving trolley, not exactly conducive to that kind of thing, so pictures are usually the way to go.
Yeah, wow.
No matter where it is, whether you're walking around through one of the squares here, or maybe even down in Forsyth Park, right on your left-hand side. So they found a 7-foot wide rock.
For a chief.
To commemorate Chief Tom Cheney and what he did for the city of Savannah, but there is also a legend. Ever since, I guess the Girl Scouts of America kind of started to conduct a little ritual that they had around Chief Tom Cheney's honorary grave. And it's been carried on by many people throughout the city of Savannah. And, well, I'll tell you guys what it is. Essentially, you go up to the rock, the memorial of Chief Tom Cheney, and you knock on it 3 times. You run around 3 times. You knock twice, say hi, Chief, and you wait. You wait long enough, you listen. You might just be able to hear. Because Chief Tom Cheney said that when people say hi, Chief, he is said to reply and say no. I mean, I have, you know, seen people going and running around this rock and knocking on it all the time, but every single time, you know, I hear people who are already having a good time that night, they're stumbling around the rock, and they finally say, get to the high chief. Well, they're listening, they start cheering, they're like, I think I heard something, he said something. I apologize, sir, that was my fault. And I have to be the one every time because, well, I work with the spirits here in Savannah, and I know I have to be the one to bring it to him every time. Well, no, he actually said nothing. I know that something, nothing, they're kind of similar, but two totally different things, guys.
He says nothing.
No. It's just a little fun thing that we like to do here in Savannah. It's a fun game to try and, you know, get your friends to go along with for a while. But other than, you know, silly Girl Scout games that we have here in Savannah, as I've been telling y'all about prior to Chief Tom Cheney, well, we have spirits galore in Savannah. And the first real stop on our tour, guys, the place that we're driving to right now, is the 1790 Inn. Now, the 1790 Inn is one of the oldest, well, still oldest still operating hotels that we have here in Savannah.
That's my favorite.
Now, it was not actually built in the year 1790. That is a misnomer. It was actually built in the early 1820s, but there was quite a bit of tragedy that was associated with that year, and so the owner of the 1790, the founder of it, well, he decided rather to name it after the year of his birth, the year 1790. So 1790 Inn was born, and ever since, people have been coming and going. The 1790 Inn is not only famous for being one of the oldest operating hotels here, but it is also one of Savannah's most famous hotspots for one of our most infamous spirits here in the city. This spirit goes by the name of Anna from Savannah. Yeah, it rhymes. It makes a little bit of fun. But Anna from Savannah, her story, over the years, the best I can say is it's gotten a little bit muddled. The details are a little bit scattered. See, she is, like I said, one of our most famous ghosts. She is one of our most, well, I guess one of our oldest spirits here in the city. of our most talked about spirits. And as such, her story, there are many iterations of it now. And so, y'all, I know that y'all have those fancy, you know, cellular devices nowadays, and Anna from Savannah's story, absolutely famous enough to, you know, you guys can find it anywhere. Any different version, but I don't want to tell you a version of it and then, you know, you guys go on and find that something I said was absolutely just either not mentioned in another story or completely contradicted in something else. So rather, I want to tell you guys about a lesser known spirit at the 1798. One that, well, y'all can probably impress your friends with, because, like I said, this one is, she's not as talked about. She's not as famous, but she is, I would say, just as important to the history of the 1798. Now, this spirit goes by the name of Miss Odessa, guys. Now, before I start on hers, I will tell you the 1790 is coming up on your left-hand side here. Now, Miss Anna from Savannah, as I said, she is one of the most famous ghosts, one of the most, well, probably one of the most popularly spotted, and her room was on the third floor. So, if you guys want to look up to the third floor, maybe let me know if she pops out of that, you guys. Sometimes she just likes to, you know, chill up there for a little bit. But guys, Miss Odessa was originally the head chef for the 1790 Inn. Right? She ran a very tight ship. 1790 Inn has always been praised for the quality of their food, and Miss Odessa was one of the ones that started them on that path. Now, she ran a very tight ship, but she was one of those, she was one of the head chefs. She was kind of like a Gordon Ramsay in the kitchen. She was abusive, but to the point where it was less constructive and more, you know, just her getting angry when people messed up. Now, oh my goodness, it looks like we have a guest that's gonna come on and speak with you guys for a little bit. So I'll let her pop on and I'll get back to Miss Odessa with you guys as soon as she gets popped off. So enjoy. Pardon me one second, you guys.
Infamous ghost of the 1790 Inn restaurant right behind us there. Now, people in the South have reputations for spreading gossip and rumors. If you yourselves have played the gossip game, you'll understand that even if a story passes from person to person, it changes drastically. There are several versions of my story floating around out there. Some say I was the owner's wife, some say I was a servant girl, and some say I was a kitchen wench. Really, a kitchen witch. But I'm here to tell y'all my favorite version of the story, one that's been told on local walking tours for decades. You see, my mother died in childbirth, and my father, a wealthy Charleston businessman, decided to raise me on his own with the help of nannies, tutors, and the like. A young man named William from Savannah began to pay social calls and eventually proposed marriage. In those days, it was not proper for a young lady to stay under the same household as a husband-to-be, so the 1790 was the premier guest house of its time and the perfect place for a woman of my standpoint. Well, as I better got to know William, I realized he did not make enough money to keep me in the financial situation of which I wished to become accustomed to, so I encouraged him to go off to England and increase his business holdings prior to our wedding day, and I spent my time with a colorful and entertaining guest of the 1790. Well, that's where my story takes a turn. You see, one day I was in the parlor, keen on my needlepoint, and I looked up and saw the most beautiful, handsome man I had ever seen in my life. Tall, strapping, a merchant sailor from Germany. All the guests were much older than I was. However, Ruff was only 21 and was as entertaining as he was handsome. Well, y'all can guess what happened next. Ralph and I carried on a torrid love affair for weeks until on one fateful day, my whole world came crashing down around me. First, the doctor confirmed that I was with child, and shortly after, I received a letter saying that William was to arrive back in Savannah the very next day. And when I ran to Ralph and told him news of our baby, he laughed. He laughed right in my face as he packed his bags and boarded a ship for England. As I watched him walk away, I was heartbroken, I was humiliated, I was ruined, I'd taken my virtue, my future, my hopes and dreams and tossed them out the window. So in a moment of dark despair, knowing that I simply could not face the world as a disgraced single mother, I followed hold my virtue, my future, my hopes and dreams, as I threw myself out the window, laying on the cold hard pavement below. And that's how I became the ghost of the 1790, one of the most talked about spirits in Savannah. And as for my behavior in the afterlife, y'all see, that's what makes me so talked about. I've often been known to steal women's lacy underthings and place them somewhere scandalous, like under the dining table of a stuffy couple. There's also a rumor I am able to visit with our handsome male guests when I'm particularly lonely, but that bit of gossip I'll neither confirm nor deny. Well, that's my version of the story. Y'all can believe whatever version you like. As they say, there's no such thing as bad press. And at this point in my afterlife, I will take whatever I can get. I'll see you all in your dreams.
Alright, guys. Well, listen, it's almost 4 o'clock in the morning. I am tired as hell. And I just want to say, I know I didn't film too much of the tour. It was kind of dark. It was kind of dark, and, you know, to be honest with you, that tour, I'm going to be honest with you, don't waste your time with it. There's another tour in Savannah. I'm sorry, guys. I mean, it wasn't terrible, but the guy who was telling stories just was kind of, I'm here. It's like he was phoning it in. I don't know. It just didn't seem right. Not that it seemed right, just that he didn't do a good job of doing the job. There were some people that did reenactments and stuff, as you saw, and that was really cool. I kind of like that. Until I have a shirt inside out. I had to go to my... Oh, no, I don't have it inside out. Well, the collar's all messed up. Sorry. But it was a great... It was good. I mean, if you want to see Savannah, go on it. It's a cool ghost tour, but there's better ones out there. So I suggest the other... If... you know, the one that's not the one that I went on. You heard the guy, whatever his name was. He was a pretty cool guy, so. But, you know, overall, it was okay. But I'm definitely going to come back to Savannah. I want to come back with Omar. And I definitely want to you know, do some more ghost hunting. I want to go back to that cemetery at night. I got to see how to do that. I got to figure it out, so. Anyways, guys, thank you guys so much for watching the video. Thank you so much for your prayers, your kind words on social media about my stepdad. It's been really hard on my mother. She's doing okay, but she thanks you too. And, you know, maybe I'll film more here in Savannah. I doubt it, but I love you guys. Thank you very much. Peace out. Boomer Nights out.